Hello everyone and welcome to Sports Gaming Universe channel here on YouTube. Welcome back to my Timberwolves Association Mode series here in NBA 2K12. Now I know you're probably saying, yeah, Monday is my normal day for NBA content, especially this series, but things got a little bit moved around because of the Memorial Day holiday, so I'm bringing you some Timberwolves Association today. I figured you wouldn't mind. So the Timberwolves return home here. If you remember the last episode, they took on the Oklahoma City Thunder on the road and were not able to keep up with Durant and company, Westbrook. Those guys took them down. And then the Timberwolves returned home and put a thumping on the Dallas Mavericks at Target Center. Well, this episode is a little bit about revenge games. First of all, the Oklahoma City Thunder now come to Target Center and the Timberwolves would like to avenge the last loss. That's what's first on the schedule. The Thunder, coming into this game, are not only the best team in the division, but they're the top team in the Western Conference, with Minnesota playing pretty well themselves, and you see Ricky Rubio hitting a jumper to get the scoring started. Oklahoma City comes back with five straight points of their own, when Rubio looking for more, oh, the floater with the left hand goes! 5-4 now, Oklahoma City. Kevin Love looking to get on the stat sheet, goes left-handed and scores. The Wolves have their first lead of the game. It's back and forth action in the first quarter, definitely. When Monte Ellis has a nice pass to Derek Williams, he finishes and gets a nice bucket, his first of the game. Okay, well, the Thunder looking to set a screen here. Well, Harden doesn't even need it. He just blasts the three and puts his team up 10-8. Yep, he can shoot the lights out if you're going to let him. Here's some passing around. Durant back to Perkins, and Perkins lays it in. 12-8 lead for Oklahoma City early. Timeout Minnesota to regroup. 12-10 at this point, when Westbrook's looking to put some fancy moves on. Oh, he's mesmerizing everybody. Hitting out to Harden, who hits the easy wide-open three. 15-10 now. Rubio looking for a good pass to Derek Williams. Oh, he's the recipient of a couple good passes early in this game. 17-14 now, Oklahoma City. Luke Ridenour in the game for the Timberwolves, who gives to Monte Ellis, who takes the three-point shot and makes it. So we've got a 17-all ball game. When Harden finds Westbrook underneath, but Petkovic recovers on the defense for the block. It is thrown up to Ellis, up court, and he slams it home. Sprite Slam Cam will show you the replay here of Monte Ellis gliding in for that silky smooth dunk. On the other side of the court, Kevin Durant brings the thunder. No pun intended. Well, okay, maybe a little bit. He slams this home two-handed. Big time jam for Kevin Durant. And he shows the Target Center crowd that Oklahoma City's here to play tonight. They're up 22-19. Ooh, little fancy move there, getting the ball to Ibaka, who puts it home. 24-21 now. Jackson in the game, looking to spin. Oh, he makes a nice move around Kevin Love, who wanted to swat that ball away, but no. Basket's good. 27-23. Kevin Love looking for a crisp pass to Rubio. Going to work it down into Petkovic. What's Pat going to do? He finds Love for the basket and one. Kevin Love will miss the free throw, but he did have the three-point opportunity. So 27-25, when Rubio is going to drive, is it a charge? Nope. They're going to call Collison on the blocking foul. It's an N1 for Rubio, and he's going to make his attempt. Three-point play for Ricky. 32-30 now. Oh, Westbrook doing his thing, spinning left, spinning right, making everybody just sick there with the dizzy moves. And the score, 34-30, when Derek Williams hits from three-point land, cuts the lead down to one. Again, it's a three-point lead. Petkovic isn't going to shoot out there. He's out of his range. You see J.J. Barea going to give off to Randolph. Randolph out to Wes Johnson. We've got some reserves hitting buckets right with the 24 o'clock winding down. That's a three. Oh, there's a nice oop by the Thunder. Keeping pace themselves, everything going fine for them. Minnesota opens up a five-point lead here into the third quarter when Rubio's looking for Kevin Love. Kevin Love's going to look, stop, pop, and hit. Okay, so they've opened up a little bit of room, their best lead of the game so far. 53-48 now, and Westbrook is going to shoot from three, and that's short, an air ball, really? Don't see that much from Westbrook. Coming on down court now is Rubio, looking to make things happen. This is a nice pass from Monte Ellis to Rubio underneath the basket. 57-50. Third quarter still. Harden, nice ball movement, but he cannot hit the three. Time for the Timberwolves to run. Up ahead to Monte Ellis, one-on-one. He's going to put this home with the right-handed layup. 59-50. They've stretched it out a little bit, but they're not done. Here you see another stop and shoot is not going to go. The Thunder just getting cold at the wrong time here. Randolph leading this one. The right-handed shot will go 61-50. It's 11-point lead. Durant says, enough of this. I got to take control. But that shot is off the rim as well. Rebound Kevin Love. Randolph up court. What's he looking for? Three-pointer from Ellis? Yes, sir. 64-50 as the third quarter winds down. On into fourth quarter action now. The Thunder will respond and try to get a little closer. They've cut it to 69-62, and they've got a chance for a fast break here. Westbrook spinning again. He'll draw contact. Almost goes in. It does not, but he makes his free throws. Okay, 69-64. 3.5 minutes left. Rubio resetting here. Going to pass to Love. Love's going to go left-handed. Yes, and get the lead just a little bit more spread out. 71-64. That's the same score here when here's a pass that is broken up by Kevin Love. He's going to get it to J.J. Barea, who comes up court. And a nice pass to Rubio underneath, and he switches to the right hand and scores. 73-66. Monte Ellis thought about three ball, but he's going to give in to Kevin Love, who makes that mid-range jumper no problem. Down the stretch, they hit a couple free throws that will seal the deal. 79-72, your final. 79-74. Minnesota avenges the loss in Oklahoma City and takes out the Thunder here on the home court at Target Center. Your player of the game is Kevin Love. Who else? Yes, sir. He had a good game today. He's had a couple games in my series of the games that I've highlighted where they weren't so great, but usually he's very solid, and he was indeed very solid on this night, getting a lot of points down low, mid-range shots. You got the hook shots. He had some steals. He had some outside shooting. He had a little bit of everything in this game that made him the player of the game. So as you see these highlights, Kevin Love gets her done here. They want to delight the home fans here with a win against the number one team in the conference, and they did just that tonight. Always good for your confidence as a team when you can beat the teams that are ahead of you in the standings and move up, if not just at least stick around in the playoff picture. And they did just that tonight. So pretty nice scoring from a lot of the team. You see, the only player that didn't get off the bench was Anthony Tolliver. Everyone contributed in some way, and many people in quite a big way. So nice play from the starters and the role players as well, getting the victory. So we're going to sim the game against the Rockets. Ooh, hey, reward. We already improved our record from last year, which wasn't too hard to do. They only had, I believe, 17 wins the year before. So 18 wins takes the cake already. So after simming a little more, we come up against a matchup with the Dallas Mavericks. And if you remember the last episode, we played the Thunder and the Dallas Mavs. Well, it is, as I said, rematch game time in this episode. So we're going to go to Dallas this time and try to show them that it was no fluke the last time around, that when we trounced them, it was because we're a good team. But oh, look out, Derek Williams. Sean Marion just posterizes you on the slam cam here. Look at this. How do those nuts taste, man? Oh, man. Look out, Derek Williams. Yeah, I have to print it out there. He got shown up there just a little bit. So he converts the three-point play. And Marion's not done. Look at this spin move. And another monster dunk. Ooh, first 5 points for Marion right here. It was Monte Ellis. He said, nope, I'm going to let you fly right by as I spin and slam this home. So Monte looking for a little revenge. Actually going to pass off to Rubio in front of his own bench. And he nails it. Three-pointer. It's 9-3 now when Rubio looking for a pass to Derek Williams. He gets a chance to show off now after getting posterized. He'll hit the three, cut it to 9-6. 9-8 ball game now when Luke Ridenour is going to shoot just inside the three-point arc and make it Minnesota's first lead, which was kind of impressive after falling behind early in the game. But Terry will hit that three-pointer, give Dallas a lead right back. More seesaw action in the first quarter. And Derek Williams going to go to Wes Johnson, who once again off the bench will hit a three. Comes in and does his roll once in a while. Nice to see. Dirk with the up and under. That's going to go. Mr. Nowitzki's on the board. It's 2015 Dallas opening up a five-point lead. Nice little feather pass into Kevin Love. He sees the double team coming. He passes that out, and Derek Williams does his job. You got to hit that wide open shot, and he does. Ricky Rubio with a little bit of room, shooting over Dirk, ties the game at 20. Okay, Brad Miller in the game? Nope, he's not shooting that shot. I'm not letting him shoot that shot. He's going to wait for somebody to come open, And that person is Kevin Love at the three-point arc, and it is good. 23-20 Minnesota second quarter. This pass out is good for a Dallas three as well. Back and forth, as I said, 30 all in the third quarter. When Rubio will hit that jumper, 32-30. I wish he was a little more consistent like that in real life with his jump shot, but I'll take it in this game. So Monte Ellis doesn't find any option underneath, so he'll just take the three ball. They're up five. Now it's 37-37, though. Dallas clawing right back when Monte goes to the left hand and scores. 39-37, third quarter. Winding down when Jason Kidd does what he does best. Nice little passing inside for the assist. 39 all. Nice pass out to Webster. Martell gives off to Randolph. Randolph out to Monte Ellis and swish. 42-39. Keeping up here into the fourth quarter when Dirk is going to do his patented move and miss. Here comes Derek Williams down the court. What's he looking for? He's going to stop back to Kevin Love for three. Wide open. Don't leave him that wide open. He'll hit that most of the time. So you see Minnesota with a four-point lead. Dirk trying to go one-on-one against Kevin Love, and he will hit there. Despite some problems earlier, he is starting to hit some shots. There's Monte Ellis missing. It's going to give Dallas a chance to run. Sean Marion. Oh, Brad Miller. I don't like the looks of this. Look out. Oh, no. Another poster shot. Marion having fun right here at Brad Miller's expense this time. Just look out if he's coming through the lane. You don't really want to be in that poster shot. Dirk is going to put that home. 52-50 Dallas. We're getting down to crunch time here. Yep. That is a three ball. Lamar Odom. Sure. 5-point lead. And now there's some real work to do with only 2 minutes left. Ricky Rubio, well, Jason Kidd didn't really seem like he wanted to get out there, so Rubio takes the shot and cuts it to two, 55-53. Okay, it's Dirk time, working on he's working on Pekovic there. Thought it was Kevin Love at first. Either way, he misses. That's pretty nice. Okay, so Ricky, yes! Another three ball gives him the lead. Ricky's on fire from three in the second half. Oh, but he decides to go double team. Bad idea, because you do not want to leave Jason Kidd that wide open. 2-point lead, Dallas. We're right down here. They decide to play some tough defense. Try to get a miss. Here's Kidd. He's going to go to the right leaner. No! Okay, rebound and timeout. Let's talk about this. Do you go for two in the tie, or do you go for three in the win? I guess it depends on what they're going to, what look they're going to give you. So coming out of the huddle, they know Rubio has been very hot from three-point range in the second half. That's an option. Looking to inbound to Rubio. He's going to get the ball and look to see if he can find anything underneath. He cannot, so he's going to take the three and oh, it's off and no good. We lose by 2 points in a game we could have had on the road. Well, it didn't go as well as it did at Target Center when we played the Mavericks. We take the loss, but it was a good game, a fun game to watch nonetheless, back and forth. You see how the players did in this game off my bench and my starters. Oh, here's a trade offer. Get out of here with that weak shit, Raptors. No, we are not trading you, Kevin Love. Just go home. Get out of my face. That's insulting. Go away. I don't want your first round pick. So we simulate past the Hornets. Sorry, Blinkfro. But I'm going to go on to the Atlanta game next time around. Do come back for that, and we'll see you next time, guys.